Yo, what is going on, everybody? This is CPA Strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. Been lifting for a bit, just like I've been doing this for a minute. I happen to have the best accounting playlist in the world, because that's what I do. I teach the world accounting through building blocks. This up here happens to be part of the best playlist in the world. Just hit it like a genie bottle, all your dreams come true. You know what it is, baby. I'm in the middle of the day. I got people coming by my office going, this kid's crazy, what's going on? We gotta get this kid out of this office, man, what's happening? But I tell you what, they could be, I'm not doing nothing but teaching the world accounting, okay? I'm not even cursing anymore. So get on with your little bad self and get on with your little life, because this is Friday night, you go party, because I'm partying for me right now, okay? We done, it's good, let's go, boom. This is number 63 of my classic series. This is a classic. This is double declining balance depreciation. All right, we just talked about accumulated depreciation. We just talked about depreciation in general, what it is, how you factor it. We just did single line depreciation. Now this is double declining balance depreciation. It's also called an accelerated depreciation method. Now, I'm gonna do a summary of this and that before, but how do you do double declining balance? What is it all about? Just like everything else that in accounting, let's pick apart the name, the title. And let's go back to straight line depreciation method for 1 second. The way I like to remember straight line, okay, the name says straight line. It's going to be the same depreciation every month, all right? So it's going to be a straight line, $1,000 one year, $1,000 the next year, $1,000. So it's a straight line of $1,000. That's straight line, okay? That's how you're going to remember that, because it's a straight line, the same every year. This is double declining balance. Double. It's gonna be double the percent of straight line, all right? So when you see double declining, you're like double of the straight line. All right, great. And it also has balance in the name of it, so it's very key, because you multiply by the book value balance. That's what you do, you multiply by the book value, the balance of the book value. So it's in the title. What are our factors? Now we have the same factors here at first, as in the straight line. We bought a truck for $5,000. Our useful life is 5 years. Those are the same factors in straight line. But now on this one, in double declining balance, we have a residual value of $500. The whole thing is straight line's the same depreciation every year for the 5 years, all right? And double declining balance is you take more depreciation in the beginning, and then at the end, each year you take less and less and less because there's a declining balance and whatever. $5,000, 5 years, we're getting our percentage. So 5 years, that's for doing so. So every per year would be 20% per year. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. That's how you get your percents. How else could you get a percentage of 5 years? 5 years, huh? 1 divided by 5, 0.2. That's also how you could do it. But anyway, so you figure out straight line's 20. Straight line would be 20%, because you're doing it for 5 years. So you're gonna take 20% every year. You would take 20% of your cost every year, and that would be $1,000 for straight line, all right? Now, you multiply your straight line, your number one, by two, but you double it up. That's in the name, double. All right, so you get your straight line percentage. Now, just like the name says, you double it. So that's gonna be the same, 40% every year. Unless, until it goes under the residual value, because you don't want to depreciate it more than it's worth at the end. step number three. You take the percentage that you got and you multiply it by the book value. And that's how you get your double declining balance. Now let's go. So really what we figured out here is 40% annual double decline annual depreciation balance. That's how much it is. Now let's just go with our facts here. And we have residual value of 500 in this example to start off with. Bought it for $5,000. There's your cost. Now the cost isn't going to change either because the cost is $5,000. That's the whole way through. Something else I did notice just doing this chart, the accumulated depreciation and the book value at the beginning of the year equals the cost. So that makes sense to everybody, I hope, because I just hope that makes sense. That's something I saw with doing these charts. First year out, you got it for, you cost $5,000. We're done with the cost. That's not even going to change. Cumulative depreciation, zero, because you haven't depreciated anything yet. Book value beginning of the year is $5,000. You multiply that by 40%, because this is the double declining balance. 5,000 times 40% is 2,000. So we're taking $2,000 depreciation this first year. You see in straight line it was 1,000 each year. 1,000, 1,000, 1,000, 1,000, 1,000. So you're going to see you're taking double at the first year. I just want you to know that, notice that. Book value is 3,000 at the end of the year. Start of the second year, you have that $2,000 accumulated depreciation. Book value of $3,000, because that was the book value at the end of the year. So that's the book value at the beginning of the year. Now we're going to multiply that by 40%. Multiply the book value and double declining balance. And now the depreciation for the second year is $1,200. That's more than the straight line. So you're taking depreciation in the early stages of the asset's useful life, and because it's an accelerated depreciation method. Leaving us with a book value of $1,800 at the end of the year. Year three, we have $3,200 of accumulated depreciation now. Book value $1,800. Multiply that by 40%, double declining balance. That is $720 of depreciation for the third year. Now, compared to the straight line of 1,000, this is less now. Now we're taking less depreciation because we already took more. Laugh now, cry later, right? Yeah. So look, that leaves us with a book value of $1,000. Accumulated depreciation of $3,940 in year four. Book value of $1,080. Multiply that by 40%. Depreciation for the fourth year, $432. Now it's really not that much. And we have end of the year book value of $648. That's our book value. The rest of the $5,000 is our accumulated depreciation, $4,352. So we only have, it's only worth on our book $648 now in our fifth year. We're taking 40% of that, but hold on a second. Where did I put my calculator, bro? If you took $648 times 40% here, 648 times 0.4, that's like $259. So if you put that would leave us with less than $500 residual value, which we don't want to do because that's how much it's going to be worth when we're done with the asset. So this last year, we're just gonna have as much depreciation allows to have our asset end with $500. So that is $148. So you can see how that's a little different than straight line. Straight line would have been $1,000 each year. But in this example, we took an accelerated method. So we took a lot more, double than straight line this year, a little bit more than straight line, less than straight line, a lot less than straight line, really, really, really a lot less than straight line. You know what, this went long enough, and this is gonna be double declining balance with residual value. The next video I'm gonna do is double declining balance without the residual value. Let's see, I got a little minute to talk. What am I gonna say? I don't know. Let's focus on bettering ourselves. Let's think about let's think about not talking about other people. You know, what good does that do? You know, talking trash about people. Just let's try to uplift other people. Let's try to do better, right? Let's try to stay positive. Let's watch my next accounting video. Let's do that. Let's like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, and I'll see you next time. Peace.